Good afternoon, I guess. We are the Sacramento Jazz Orchestra. Thank you guys for being here to join us with our presentation of a lot of original compositions for you. And the first one you did was a composition of mine entitled Panda's Premise. It's a tune I wrote for a great friend of mine that ended up moving to Sweden, so we don't talk anymore. No, we talk, I'm just kidding. But yeah. And so that was entitled Panda's Premise, and that featured Josh Murray on the tenor sax. And Brendan Lowe on the piano. So after looking at our set list, hope that's not my daughter. Why is she? Anyway, all right. A lot of the songs that we have there's a common theme of people, and we have, you know, songs written for friends, written for family members, written for fellow musicians, and this one does not fit any of those categories. A lot of my works have stories and are about people, but this one doesn't have any. And this is entitled Sequential Thoughts, and it's going to feature Steve Roach on the flugelhorn. You can clap, it's okay. Mark Tolga on the alto sax. And you'll hear once again from Brendan Lowe on the piano.
Hello, everybody. So I'm introducing the next tune that just happens to be an original composition of mine that Joe Mazzaferro so wonderfully arranged for the band. And this tune is entitled Previn's Playground, written for my middle son, Previn. And I wanted to write something special for him on an album that I recorded some years ago. And in trying to sort of find what would be fitting for a tune, I sort of went to his disposition and sort of his rosy outlook on life. And, you know, he's, of course, a good-looking kid. And and so I wanted something that was sort of bubbly, that sort of, you know, had a bright outlook. And, of course, I thought, well, let me go back to the days of the Boogaloo in the late 60s and 70s. And so I wrote a Boogaloo for him entitled Previn's Playground. This is going to feature Mr. Max Kiesner on the trumpet. Mr. Mike Soulier on the trombone. And yours truly. We hope you enjoy Previn's Playground. Thank you.
In August of 2014, we lost an award-winning composer and arranger and a very passionate music educator to a long battle with cancer. Fred Sturm's teaching career spanned over 37 years, primarily as the program director of jazz studies at Lawrence Conservatory, but also spent a short stint as the improvisational chair at the Eastman School of Music. And through his career, he's inspired and mentored hundreds, if not thousands, of students. He'll be long remembered for his passion and dedication to music composition and teaching. But he was also, people who knew him on a personal basis, he was an incredible practical joker. So I had the pleasure of experiencing some of that growing up in my home state where he taught. So we're going to feature one of his tunes. This is titled Patience, and I'd like to draw your attention to our drum set player, Rick Lauder. This is a feature for drums and focus on his incredible brushwork. We hope you enjoy Patience by Fred Sturm.
one more time for these wonderful players. Thank you. Thank you all for being here, too, on such a rainy day. Is it still raining now? No? Okay. We've been in here since 9:30. Next tune I wrote when I was performing and actually in a workshop clinic situation with the great Nicholas Payton from New Orleans, and it's called Concentric Circles. And a lot of times during the workshop, we were working actually with Russian students, that first time here in America, and we had a great opportunity to share improv with them. And a lot of times this word would come up with Nicholas when we would work together with it in a team setting, just him and I with the students. And he said, concentric circles, think about that, guys. Like you drop a rock or a stone in a pond and it goes out. He says, you don't have to start like at nothing of your soul and then go all the way up to something like, you know, magnificent. You can just make it grow organically. So I started thinking about that word, concentric circles, all the way during the week, through the week. And the tune was written like maybe in 20 minutes, just on a break. And I showed it to him and he says, yeah, that's what I'm talking about. That kind of idea. So concentric circles, that idea could also flow into writing music and performing music. It doesn't have to just be soloing. This song features the great Phil Tolga on trombone, and the arrangement was done by a wonderful trumpet player we have in this group, Joe Mazzaferro, back there. He did a wonderful job. I can't thank him enough for this. And so here we go in a sort of a folky tune. You'll like it, maybe, hopefully.
And Joe Mazzaferro did the arrangement on this. Beautiful solo with Phil Tolga. My name is Mike McMullen. I'm very proud to, first of all, be a part of this ensemble, and second of all, to be able to present a concert here for you today. The next piece we're going to play is a bit of a change-up. This piece started about 18 months ago. My mother passed, and while I was going through old photo albums, and there were many decades of albums to look at, and just pulling pictures and spreading them around and trying to figure out maybe to put something together for just montages and things for a memorial, I had all these photos spread around, and they seemed like leaves falling off a tree. And the overall impression I had as I looked is I could see her whole life kind of reflected around me, and also my own life. And that just brought a certain feeling. And so this is a piece, this is entitled Picture Book, and it's a piece of reflection and contemplation.
Thank you.
One more time for Mike McMullen. So this next piece we're going to do for you is a piece that I composed in 2012 during the summer. And that was my first time back at Casadero Music Camp, which has been a huge part of my family for many, many years after the founder had passed away. And so instead of writing something that was more of an elegy dedicated to him, I wanted to write something that really reflected kind of what a day at this particular place, Casadero Music Camp, was like. And if you've never been there, it's in the Sonoma County, western Sonoma County, kind of off the coast, just inland a little bit, and there's nothing but just gorgeous, tall, beautiful redwood trees. And so I entitled this in honor of him, Beneath the Redwood Trees. And this is going to feature myself and Patrick Langham on the soprano sax. Thank you.
So, in long concerts, it's quite common to start wondering, when's the ending? So, we are going to end with a piece called The Ending. Just so everyone knows it's the ending. The concept for this piece comes from the fact that every language has cliches and phrases that are sort of shortcuts to underlying meaning. And music is no different, and jazz is no different. And so what I thought I might do is, instead of using a particular cliche as a shortcut, I would see if it was possible to develop an actual piece out of a cliche. So everything in this piece comes from the very first phrase, which is the ending.
We'll be right back.
Thank you all very much for attending today. It was our pleasure to play as part of FENAM for you. We're all done, so you can remain standing if you like. Sacramento Jazz Orchestra. Sacramento Jazz Orchestra.